Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to look at a game-changing app that links your iPhone to your Windows PC. And best of all, this is completely free. By linking your iPhone to your PC, you can transfer files from your phone to your PC and from your PC to your phone just by dragging and dropping, and it's all wireless. You can also view all of your phone's photos directly on your PC. You can send and receive text messages, you can make phone calls, and you can even view all of your phone's notifications directly on your PC. This also works with Android phones, but this has been possible with an app that comes with Windows called Phone Link. For iPhones though, this hasn't been possible. That is, until now. Let's check this out. Here I am on my Windows PC, and first off, we need to install an app called Intel Unison. This is a completely free app and it just recently came out. You could click on the link up above or also down below in the description and that'll drop you on this page. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on Get In-Store App. This opens up an install prompt and right here, let's click on Install. Once it's all done installing, let's click on Open. This opens up Intel Unison. Down at the very bottom, let's click on Accept and Continue. Here, I'll allow it to share crash data and statistics back with Intel. That way they can make the app better. Next, we need to install Intel Unison on your phone. And there are a few different ways to do that. Here, you could click on this icon to get it through the store. You could also get a text message or what I found to be the easiest way, simply open up the camera app on your phone and then aim it at this QR code here. And that'll bring you directly to the store page. This now opens up the store page for Intel Unison on my phone, and right up on top, I'll click on this icon to install the app. Once the app is all done installing, let's tap on Open. This opens up the app, and just like on the PC down below, let's click on Accept and Continue, and here I'll allow it to share crash data and statistics back with Intel. Next, I need to give permission to access all of these different items on my phone. Here, I'll click on Let's Go. And now it asks me for permission, so I'll go through and click on OK. Next, we need to once again scan a QR code, but this time to pair our phone with the PC. Here, I'll click on Scan QR Code. Here, I'll give access to the camera. And here, it's now captured the QR code from my computer screen. Here, I'll verify that the same code shows up on both devices, and on my PC, I'll click on Confirm. It has now successfully installed on both my phone and on my PC. Let's now take a look at what some of the capabilities are. On my phone, in the bottom right-hand corner, I'll click on this blue icon, and here I can transfer files from my phone to my PC. I'll click on Gallery, and let's see, I really like this photo right here. I'll select that, and in the top right-hand corner, I'll click on Add. And just like that, it has finished sending the photo from my phone to my PC. Over here on my PC, I can see that the transfer is complete. If I hover over the file, here I can click on this folder icon, or alternatively, in the bottom left-hand corner, I could click on Downloads. And here I see a folder for photos, and if I click on this, here I can see that photo from my phone directly on my PC. That's pretty easy. It's just as easy sending the files the other way. Here on my PC, I could simply drag and drop files into this window, and that'll transfer them to my device. Or I could also click on Add Files, and let's take this photo right here. I'll select that. And that is now transferring or sending the photo to my phone. On my phone, in the top left-hand corner, I'll click on the Received tab, and here I can see that photo. On my phone, in the photo gallery, here I also see the photo. So it's really simple to transfer files back and forth between your PC and your phone. Back on my PC, over on the left-hand side, let's click into the gallery view. And here I can see all the photos that are on my phone, but here I'm looking at them on my PC. So that's pretty cool. Up on top, I can also filter the view. Currently, I'm just looking at all of the photos, but here I could filter it to just videos. And up above, I could also view all of the albums on my phone. In the top right-hand corner, I can also change the view. Here, I could select the thumbnail size, and I could also switch between square view or full view. So a number of different options here. Along with viewing all of your photos and videos, you can also transfer them between devices from this view. So let's say that I really like this photo right here. Here, when I hover over it, in the top right-hand corner, I can click on this download icon. And here, that's transferred the photo from my phone to my PC. And let's say that I want to bulk transfer files or photos from my phone to my PC. Here, I could click on this icon, and I can press the shift key. So let's say I want to select all of these photos. I could click on this download icon in the top right-hand corner, and that'll bulk download all of these photos. I'll click on the X to cancel. And I could also upload from this view. Here, I could click on upload, and I could select photos and videos from my computer and then send them over to my phone. So a number of different ways to transfer files between your devices. Over on the left-hand side, I can also send and receive text messages directly on my PC. Within this view, I'll click on this icon to compose a new message, and now I can type in the name of a contact. Here, I'll select my brother, and down below, let me type in, did you like the cookies I sent you? I know he's gonna say yes, but let's just double check. Down here, I'll click on the send icon, and I now just sent him a text message. Over on the left-hand side, let's click into calls. And here you can make and receive phone calls, and it'll use your computer's microphone and also speakers. Here on the left-hand side, you could simply call one of your contacts, or you could also just dial in any phone number. Back over on the left-hand side, you can also see all of your phone's notifications directly on your PC. As the notifications come in, you'll see a toast in Windows, or here you could review all of your notifications. Down in the very bottom left-hand corner, there are two more different icons. One of them is for downloads, and this is where it saves all of your received files, so all the files you send from your phone to your PC. And when I click on that, you can see what the default location is. If you want to change this location, you can click into Settings, and under General, at the very bottom, you can define what that save location is. You also have a few other settings that you could look at and configure to your heart's content. All right, well, hopefully you were able to link your phone to your Windows PC. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.